Oke.
Microsoft Internet Explorer.
Yeah. It's not on.
It's on.
Okay. Oh, okay. Okay, hi. My name is Riza. So, in here I just want to share with you regarding the Microsoft Edge. Actually, I don't know much about it. Only that it's already released and is I tested, and then this one is just to from Microsoft side, we want to share as much as we can regarding the Microsoft Edge, which is the Edge HTML rendering engine. And this is because some of us as a developer, web developer for example, think that this is maybe some sort of IE, mix of IE, that kind of thing, okay? So let me try to explain everything. And this is from Microsoft. Usually in my meetup, I become myself, so this time I have to choose my wording. Okay, so the title is Meet the Edge HTML. Number one, there is no new HTML. It's just the name of the rendering engine, Edge HTML. Number one, because there is a question is asking, what, Microsoft is creating another HTML? No, it's enough. Enough is enough. No more. Okay? It's no more. So maybe you remember this. Yes. And the more painful side is this one. You can see the age of Trident is the same like the age of JavaScript. It's 20 years. So from Internet Explorer 1 up to Internet Explorer 11, we're using the same engine. Okay. Believe it or not, the legacy one from 1 to they are never changed. It only adds something new. For example, this one. Remember this? The doc type, quirks, strict in the Trident. Anyone use IE5 before? No? You use IE5? You see, you remember how pain.
IE2.
You use IE2. Okay, that's good.
It was a great route at the time, actually.
That time, yes, because, And then, IE6, yes, the beginning of the disaster for me. This is starting become it's like a no way round, you know. But well, that time there's no choice. And then we jump around to IE8, but you can see that this the document mode. I think you know IE has document mode. So instead of updating the engine, Microsoft add lots of new document mode. And IE8, you can see the HTML4, ES3, CSS2, and then CSS2.1. Nothing happened. You can see they just add the UA compatible user agent. And then IE9, the same. IE10, getting worse. IE11, worse for the legacy, but good for the new HTML5 because it's already moving to the modern web. Anyway, I feel like this. You know, seriously, that's what I feel. Everything that we create, for example, I create the web, everything running JavaScript, everything tested in Chrome is working fine. Testing in Safari is working fine, and then the Edge HTML, Oh, see, even I do that in typo. Sorry about that. Edge HTML is our new web rendering engine. Let me just edit that. Because seriously, I just do it. I just add this page just now. Okay. So the idea is like this. The web should just work for everyone, for users, developers, and businesses. So Microsoft think a lot of the painful time for the browser. I think it's May 2014, and decided enough. That's it. No more IE, something like that. Okay, it is. So that time is decided to create something new. And the idea is the web should just work. Simple for everyone. So don't care whether you're coding for anything. Once you run it, once you open in Edge, it's supposed to work exactly like what you want. That's the idea, okay? It's not easy. So remember this? Interoperability means the web just work. You remember this? IE hate, who knows that, from where? It's famous, it's in the very famous social networking site. They have this JavaScript, for example. Well, in Chrome, the error does not occur. The XML is appended successfully, blah, blah, blah. For some reason, IE seems to be calculating, wrong. And no matter how, I pass the KO object. The child window, something got lost, horrible behavior in IE, everything. Why does the following code throw an unspecified error, something like that? It happens in IE, okay? But for some reason, the guy who developed this, who write this code, he joined the Web Summit 2015. I think it's on May as well. So he admitted that some of the specification of IE is correct, actually. It should return an error. So he tested the Chrome, Safari, and Firefox, make a consensus. Don't generate the error. So for some reason, okay, IE also say, okay, let's remove that. It's not become an error, you know. So it's become a standard. And a lot of JavaScript to work around that kind of thing. And I'm just going to go through. This is one reason. The other reason is this. You see in Firefox, it's rendering like that. In Safari, it's rendering like that. And IE, look at that. Yeah. It happens to my web. I create a website for e-commerce, for a book, e-commerce in Indonesia. It happens like this as well. What the hell? What is going on? Okay. So what they did is enough, and then Microsoft create this rendering engine, a fork from the past. So they get the old IE 11, they split everything, throw the shit out. Seriously, they throw the shit out. And then it's about 220,000 lines of code, real code, it's not space, real code. 6 document modes, 300 API removed. Okay, and they Microsoft create the new 300,000 added new line, which is 49 new major features. It was a fork from the past. Yeah. So it's a learning curve for Microsoft that the browser you cannot extend. Instead, you just to have to recreate from zero. Maybe it's the only company now that learns that lesson very well. I hope Safari, Apple Safari also learned that lesson. Oh. Yeah. Yes. Yes.
I hope so too.
Yes, exactly. How many years? Never change, eh? Yeah. They just keep adding, okay? Yeah. So Microsoft Edge is interoperable. Sorry. And interoperable app, I just want to little bit give some highlight about the old one. Yeah, this one, just go through. This is, So this is the difference. The Edge HTML is the default engine interoperability and for modern HTML websites, and this one is the compatibility. This is the document mode. Have a reason, Microsoft have a reason to keep this document mode, because a lot of applications running in the world, in the enterprise world, is using IE. Like us, if there's new browser, new engine, we tend to try, isn't it? But for company, enterprise, believe it or not, some of them still using IE6. But that's why Microsoft cannot remove the document modes, okay? But in Microsoft Edge, it's gone, no more. So for the legacy apps, Microsoft rely on the old IE11, which is still available in Windows 10. That's the last thing you can use for the old document mode. But the new web browser is modern web, totally modern web. And I think you know this one. Yes, the lies. You know the pack of lies. You know that, eh? Look at this. Mozilla 5.0. Netscape 6, 1997. Seriously? Okay. But look at that. I also add in here, yeah. But some of the developer, web developer, they do UA sniffing. That's the problem. So they sniff. If Chrome do like this, if Mozilla do like this, if Edge do like this, or if IE do like this. So instead of creating the good HTML5 and JavaScript and CSS, they break the HTML. Okay? So it's not doing the proper HTML5. Instead, they just break. It's because of this. Okay? And I think, remember this? Anyone using this? I do. What is this? Yes, just to check whether it is a mobile. We haven't added Windows mobile phone. So every time there's new mobile product, it will add in here, and this one is become a mess now. Okay? It's become a problem. So this one, Microsoft learned everything by doing all the research for 5 years, I think. I remember, it's, I think it's 5 years to before saying that enough. Okay? So it's not like just yesterday, you know. It's already like a long time. So currently, to date, 4,000 plus bugs is removed from the main engine. Okay, and it's become the new Edge HTML. It's not using IE engine, no more Trident. So it's the real new engine, create from zero and removing this kind of bugs. So Microsoft found this bug is because, for example, a lot of Chromium, or a lot of JavaScript doing this, a lot of HTML doing that. So they finally found this is the web that people use now. So that one, that the thing is not there, remove. Okay? For example, like this one. This, it happens like this in IE11 on Windows 8.1, and then MS Edge support for WebKit transition, it shows the correct website. Okay? Also, this one, Windows Phone 8.1, you see that? By adding the new user agent, it works. So this is Microsoft doing the research at the back. And then, where is it? Yeah. And removing security constraint and download phone, the fonts, and this font is showing. Okay? So the learning is like that. Oh, so this is why the web developer did, actually. So it follows that rule. Also, this one, for example, you see, it's supposed to be a gradient in here, but it's not showing. Not only in IE. I think in Firefox also it's not showing correctly. But, and then, with adding some code, WebKit gradient, it works. This one as well, you see the swipe doesn't work. and it becomes good. Everything is work. So here's the map. Here's the Internet Explorer, Firefox, Chrome, Safari. This is the mobile website. This is the desktop. What Microsoft did is remove this, the entire chunk, done. And then adopt this. This is the web that actually running in the world now. So the interoperability features available 4,200 plus fixes this all thing has been fixed in Microsoft Edge. Some of them is still not finished because it's still undergoing in development, but you can check the status is in here, dev.modern.ie/status, then you can see everything it's under development. How about JavaScript? You know that Edge is using ES script, ECMAScript 2015, okay? Yeah, I did test that. It cannot run in Chrome, cannot run Safari, but it run in Edge. It does not mean that they're not going to do it. Chrome will be updated, don't worry about that. The thing is, Microsoft now don't want to, there's no more racing. But let the people that create a web and the people that use the web can be happy. That's the idea now. Yes, seriously. So Microsoft don't care about the speed. You're not going to racing about this. Don't care. As long as you cannot run in here perfectly, you cannot run in here perfect, but you can run in Edge, for example, done. That's what Microsoft idea. So even someone doing this, Octane is what? Google. Google or yeah, the testing for, yeah. So this is the speed. This is not from Microsoft, it's from, I think it's from Google. And this one is from, and the Edge is evergreen. There will be no more new Windows and then new IE, no, or new Edge, no. The Edge and the Windows has a different updating. The good thing is Edge now, the update is not from Microsoft. It's from us. We give the feedback. Microsoft will do that. The same like the Windows. Now the Windows 10 that you see is from 5 million people that give the idea. And Microsoft read one by one, group it, and follow it. Including the Edge now. I'll show you the link at the end. If you don't like it, you say it. It's only 3 times Edge changing because some developer don't like it. It changed. Microsoft changed it again. Don't like it. Until everyone agrees. Okay, this is the one. Something like that. Seriously, it's us now who control Edge. If you don't believe me, you put something that you really want, and a lot of people in the world support that, Microsoft will edit that feature. Okay? So you can go to this dev.modern.ie to read everything about that. And the current release, the one that I use, this Windows 10, 10166, build 10166, already can do for web development. So you can start download and you can use it as if you want to test Edge. Including the F12 tools, as usual, everything. You see that ugly, yeah. It'll be no more. Done. So the idea is now to tell the web developer to use a proper HTML5. Follow the rule. Follow the rule of HTML5 and everything will run smooth. But if you don't follow, you follow something else, it's okay. Microsoft Edge will capture that, will put as one of the fix internally. So until now, trillions of data being crawled to website around the world. Still crawling now. Finding the telemetry is like crazy. Until this is the problem, until meets the no more difference. Even 3% slightly for the JavaScript speed, Microsoft very concerned, and now it's already like 99%, nearly fastest, the fastest. Okay, the page is like this, and you see there is a feedback. Yeah, there will be a feedback there. You can send a feedback, and you can vote. You can vote inside. You just click anything in here. For example, like this one, you vote, and yeah, the more you vote, you will get it. Or you can do like this, user voice. This is an example. You see the vote? Microsoft Edit, add to Edge, Microsoft Edge. Okay? So the web developer and the people that use the browser will be happy with that. So no more, this is Microsoft's technology, this is, no. It's our technology. We're the one who control that.
And open source it.
Huh?
They should open source it. Put that in the user voice.
Yes. I read, I saw the video, one of the video from the, if, why Microsoft don't use the current engine, which is, what is it? The Chrome engine?
WebKit.
Yeah, why don't use that? No, Blink. Why don't use Blink? Something like that. And Microsoft just responded like this. It's better have diverse engine, but as long as it's always up to date, it's better like that. So, and Microsoft will not going to add features instead of fixing, making new of that feature. So it's not like just adding this without thinking about this. Okay, should be good lah for web developer. So I need your help because you are an expert. I know you are influencers in JavaScript, in HTML. I need your help. This. So, for example, like this one, do not use UA sniffing. Don't detect edge. No need. I'm not saying it's okay, you want to do that. Some of the website I saw in Singapore is already detecting if IE equals to edge. There's no... edge will not just go.
Don't put it in the UA then.
Huh?
It should just not put
there is no UA compatibility. There is no ActiveX in edge. There is no anything. So UA compatibility is gone. For example, in the specification, I cannot give you all this because a lot of specification, you just go to modern IE, there is a lot of new spec, it is gone. I think it's 600 in IE, no more. So, for example, yeah, it's okay, they want to sniff, Edge will just go. But, I mean, what for? As a web developer, you know that Edge will not going to read that. Why we put UA sniffing? Yeah.
If your UA is exactly the same, even if from here on,
yeah,
then there's no way you can even detect its edge in the first place. There's no problem.
As long as you are doing the right HTML, it will render correctly.
Yeah, but the browser, if it doesn't identify itself as edge, prevents the coders from identifying it.
Okay. Avoid UA sniffing as much as possible.
I know we should. Yeah. People will, yes. But if you don't identify yourself as edge, they can't sniff you.
In the UA string, they have edge 12.0.
Yeah,
yes.
Get rid of that.
As in, why don't you just like Microsoft just say, I'm Ninja Turtle? Then nobody can sniff you.
Cannot. Looking like that. Because the UA string is part of the web development. You cannot remove that. You just add. But does not mean that, for example, if you're using Edge or using... Are you going to sniff for Mozilla, for example? Serious? No, that's what I mean. Yeah, something like that. So, why you sniff for Edge? Because there's no UA compatible. Because there's no UA compatibility. UA compatible in the HTML. So people think that if Edge is, it's like they treat Edge like IE. No need. You just treat as like normal HTML5. That's the message. No need to treat Edge like IE. No need to put if Edge do this, if you know, no need. You just treat Edge like the normal HTML5 browser and it will work. Something like
that. Anybody here actually using user agent sniffing at all?
Yeah, this is one of the examples. Actually, the other one is, for example, do use feature detection. For example, yeah. Feature detection. It's better to use feature detection. Because, you know, sometimes, you know, they put in the CSS and the JavaScript, they use this one, and then they use for one for Chrome, one for Mozilla, you know, which is not the correct way. So it's better to use, I use Modernizer, make it easy, just put Modernizer, done. Because it's industrial standard and is used by enterprise, for example. Just put it, done. Something like that.
You need to explain me something, though. So there's one feature here that does the same thing that another does. The second one has, like, 8 times the votes, but the first one is under development. Whereas the second one is already supported by 3 other browsers.
Mm-hmm.
Like, obviously, we're talking about WebRTC and Microsoft deciding to go for ORTC instead of what everybody else does and what gets the most votes. Maybe you can find out, like, some more information for me about why that's...
You can ask Chris later, because Chris is the one who... he's the R&D guy. I don't know the answer for that. Because...
On the website, actually.
Yeah.
It's like 3,000 votes here.
I know.
Currently not planned. And then the other one is like 600 votes in development.
Yeah, it's something like... Previously, you know, in IE, Microsoft, for example, crawl only 9,000 websites in the world. Do you believe it or not? I said, what? 9,000 only? I was shocked when I said, what? So to get the engine, the new engine, for example, new IE, Microsoft crawl only 9,000 websites. And it becomes a pattern example of the new update. But now it's not. It's like trillions of pages is crawling and then finding the... Okay. Don't worry about that. If you think need to be... what do you call it, furnish or something like that, you just send a feedback, okay? Send to the feedback. You go to dev.modern.ie, send a feedback. And for the tough question, which is, I don't know, the R&D guy, you can talk with...
if you happen to know or find out who that is.
I did get that kind of thing, but some of them, I still cannot say anything because it's under development.
No, right? If user agent contains Edge, then write most fucked up website ever.
Maybe. Okay, so that's the idea for an example, because this one is the most issue on the web that Microsoft will detect. It's not only for IE or for Edge, for even for Chrome, for Safari. It worked in Firefox well, it does not work in Safari because of this. It does not work well in Chrome, or it works well in Chrome, does not work well in Safari, is because of this as well. That's why Microsoft send a message, tell the web.
It's never going to work. No matter how many times you put that in slides, it's never going to work.
It's okay, yeah.
And the reason that the snipping hasn't been removed, the reason we still have the clearly identified agents, is because bugs go out there and they're versioned.
Yeah.
So the only way to get around it is to snip.
Exactly,
that's
I know.
That's pretty much every major library does it.
Yep.
That's the answer.
Yeah, the easiest way is for you is just to, if you think it's like that, why don't you open it in Edge?
See
whether is it running normally or not. Something like that. So actually, I challenge you, anything that you think is not working in IE, run it in Edge, for example. Yeah, go ahead, for example. If it is not working, send me an email. Seriously, I will send to the guy. And they will fix it. They will fix it, for sure. Because, again, it's not about the browser itself, but it's about the web, people using the web in the world, and the developer also. Yeah. So if I were you, I just give you a suggestion. I support this because it's not about Microsoft, okay? Because of headache. Headache if it's too many standard. Like too many, for example, like too many standard. I cannot tell you the numbers, but yeah, too many standard. You don't notice that in the real world, some of them create their own standard for the web. So each web in the world, not talking Singapore, but it's a lot. Okay. The telemetry is sending information which is I never seen before. Seriously, in the world, it's like this. So there is no standard web actually in the world. There is no standard. Cannot find one standard. even though W3C, I saw it, is like they use, for example, you can see the documentation. Even they say it's standard, but yeah. So Microsoft create Edge just to just work. The idea is just just make it work. Whatever you do, just make it. Even you want to target Chrome, I want to target Chrome only. Go ahead, run it in Edge. It will run, work normally, just like that. If you just want to target one browser, mobile browser, for example, or target Safari, go ahead. You just create, if you want to test, I already tested. You just create only specific, only for Safari, run it in Edge. It will run normally, something like that, okay? So yeah, that's for me. Maybe tough question, please don't ask me. Because seriously, I support the JS conference. Microsoft supported, yes. Hopefully, yeah. Hopefully, Chris will be there. You can ask tough question regarding this, because he's the one.
Thank
he's
you
the spoiling. Boss. He's the boss. Oh, seriously?
It's nothing enough,
huh?
But it's fine.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry about that.
Ah. No worries.
Spoiler alert. Sorry about that. Okay. Any question regarding this? So I need your help, because I also do the web developing. Yeah, we just do that. We just use the proper HTML, proper JavaScript, CSS. It will work fine. No need to do this, to do that for Edge. It will just work. Even if you want to target IE11, you just create only for IE11. You think it will not work in Chrome, you will think it not work in, but it will work in Edge. Or you just target only for one browser. It will just run in Edge, okay?
If you can get Edge to run, because it won't work on OS X or Linux or Android.
Yeah, a lot of people asking that. So maybe small demo. Yeah, here it is. Okay.
Is that you, Tim, on the
Tim on the right?
Yeah, seriously. It is like you.
Have you filmed your own presentation?
Is there a sound in here? No? Yep, just wanna.
Maybe now that you spoiled it anyway, you can go to his website.
I think we're really at an inflection point for the web. Looking back, a major new browser only comes out every 5 to 10 years. And for Microsoft, we've only had one, and it's been around for 20 years.
We realized that it was very, very hard for us to make an engine that would stretch across 20 years of content on intranets and on the open web. So that's why we decided to split the engine and have an older engine for content made only for IE, and a newer engine that we can always keep up to date for the open internet.
IE has been the browser used through the decades by millions of people around the world. And with the new rendering engine, that lets us sort of clean shop. It lets us get rid of the old things that were from the past that might have haunted web developers today.
So the first thing I think that hits you when you come to work on a web browser is the scale of the problem. You learn that the web is 44 billion websites. And then you start to think, okay, I can't cover 44 billion websites, so we need to start to prioritize.
In the past, the Internet Explorer team always tested against the top 10,000 sites or top 9,000 sites. We had a metric that we used to basically say that we are as compatible or more compatible than we were in the previous release. It turns out that's not enough. It turns out that the tail of the web matters.
The rest of the web is gigantic, and people go to very, very different sites. So we got a lot of bug reports from people close to Microsoft and people all over the world where their local school website wouldn't work or their barbershop website wouldn't work. And these are sites that would never be in the top 9,000. So just focusing on the top 9,000 doesn't give you a browser that works for everybody all the time.
So what we decided to do instead was use the crawler to detect patterns that exist in the tail of the web and in the head of the web. We crawl millions of URLs every night, and the Bing crawler itself crawls trillions of URLs monthly. As we crawl the web, we fix patterns instead of sites. And by fixing patterns, sites just end up working.
So even though we're never going to be done with compatibility problems, I think what we've done in this release with the engine split, bringing up the new rendering engine, is we've really laid a foundation and a set of best practices and engineering processes on the team that's going to really allow us to evolve more quickly and react in a much more agile way to compatibility issues and get them fixed out for our users and developers in a more timely manner.
We're not abandoning standards. In the past, we had a very spec-purity approach, and that really isn't the best way to do it. You have to be a little bit more pragmatic when you build a web browser, but you also have to work with the other browser vendors and with the W3C to ensure that the specs accurately reflect what all the browsers do and what web developers want to do.
Project Spartan Journey has been about sharing our plan, what we're building, why we're building it, and what we're going to build next, earlier than ever before. We launched our platform roadmap, which developers can know what standards we're looking at. We launched User Voice, where they can provide ideas and vote on what should be next. We are active in Stack Overflow, on GitHub, and on Twitter, seeking feedback daily. This is very much a community process, and we want to take the feedback from developers and users to help shape the product well before it ever ships.
Evergreen is really about acknowledging that the web is this constantly evolving thing. You need a web browser that also moves at the speed of the web. And with Windows 10 as a service, we're going to be able to evolve Project Spartan at the speed of the web.
In the 5 years that I've worked on the browser at Microsoft, I've not seen as much innovation and dedication to the products as in this release. We've fixed over 3,000 issues. We've implemented over 45 different new standards. The pace of development here is impressive. I'm really proud of that, and I can't wait to see where we go next.
For me, thank you very much. I hope you like it.